Welcome to Chefography Me. Today I have one of my best friend, Chef Insaf. He's going to teach us today how to cook a nice beef biryani. Welcome to Chefography, Chef.
Thank you, Shin. My name is Chef Insaf. Today I'm going to cook beef biryani in rice cooker. 1 kilo soaked basmati rice, 1 kilo beef, salt, yogurt, onion, ginger garlic paste, garam masala, chili powder, and turmeric powder. I'm going to marinate beef now. 1 teaspoon salt, 4 teaspoon yogurt, 2 sliced onion, 1 teaspoon ginger garlic paste, 1 teaspoon garam masala, 1 teaspoon chili powder, 1 teaspoon turmeric powder. Marinated beef is ready. I'm going to give 30 minutes. Now I'm going to fry some cashew nut, some raisin, some onion. It's going to be biryani garnish. Now I am going to cook beef for biryani, some corn oil, green chili, garlic and ginger garlic paste, onion, salt, mint leaves and coriander leaves, my spices.
This is a rice cooker we talked about it earlier. That's why Chef Insaf is here, his specialty. You can use any rice cooker you want. We're going to cook everything inside this rice cooker.
This is my spices. Onion is almost getting ready. I'm going to add this, some of my spices. I'm going to add some coriander and mint leaves. Now I'm going to cook now marinate beef.
Fantastic beef is ready. Let me open. I'm going to move this to a different pan to cook the rice. We need the same pot to cook rice. So,
Chef, these are the spices I'm going to add biryani rice.
Wow, nice. I like that. So we have the basmati rice, we have corn oil, we have our nice fresh ghee. Yeah?
Yes,
fresh ghee. Whole garam masala, which contain bay leaf, cinnamon stick, black and green cardamom, star anise, cloves and black pepper, and some mace, which is going to be very nice for the flavor, right?
Yes, sir.
And we have nice citric acid going to the beef.
Yeah.
And we have tomato, mint leaves, coriander leaves, rose water and salt.
Now I'm going to add the rice mixed with the masala. Kilo rice, I'm going to pour 1.5 liter water. I'm going to add 3 tablespoon salt. Lime, 3 tablespoon rose water, coriander leaves, mint leaves,
this part of magic is done. That's a rice cooker. Everything is inside. Let's wait 20 minutes. Everything should be ready. And the rice is cooking all the way down. Let me close this.
Raita for biryani. Some yogurt, salt, and cucumber, and coriander stumps. Rice is ready. Now I'm going to steam it, beef with the rice, again 5 minutes more. Now the rice is ready, the beef also is ready already. Now I'm going to prepare one by one. I'm going to add some rice first, layer. Second layer is a beef. Now I'm going to add some garnish for the biryani. Some mint leaves. Also some ghee, fresh ghee. We will close it on 10 minutes. biryani is ready now. We need to remove. It's going to serve now. Beef biryani is ready. I'm going to put some garnish.
Chef, the best biryani is ready. I'm so impressed with you. Let us taste all together, yeah? I know this. See, amazing. And you cook cucumber rice, huh? Wow. Chef, thank you so much. Let us enjoy this biryani and I make sure you will come back soon as well. Thank you very much.
Please subscribe to our channel and click on the little bell for new videos.
Welcome to Chefography Me. Now I'm going to cook a cauliflower burger, which is very nice and vegetarian option. Very simple ingredients. We have white cauliflower, purple cauliflower, tomato, lime, avocado, red onions, a gluten-free burger bun, my spice, we will explain to you what is later, salt and olive oil. Just simple as that. I want to blanch the cauliflower right now. I'll put some salt, bit of olive oil into the boiling water. Here we go. Cauliflower is just blanched enough. I'm going to seal them in this pan. There is no oil at all. Bit of the spices. A
Please subscribe to our channel and click on the little bell for new videos.
Welcome to Chefography Me. Today I'm going to cook crumb fried chicken. You might have seen thousands of recipes for crumb fried chicken, but I'm going to do something very different. That's my key ingredient, banana chips. I'm going to powder them and crumb the chicken. I'm going to fry. You have chicken breast, banana chips, 2 eggs, buttermilk, salt, pepper, lime, and tomato. Banana crumbs. Buttermilk soaked chicken. Soaked enough. Looks very nice. The banana chips crumbs ready as well. Thank you.
Please subscribe to our channel and click on the little bell for new videos.
Welcome to Chefography Me. Now I'm going to cook millet risotto. It's a very good lunch or dinner dish. This is an absolute vegetarian dish. I'm using foxtail millet, white cauliflower, purple cauliflower, romanesca, which is the same family as cauliflower and broccoli. Got some chopped garlic, chopped onions, coconut milk, lime, olive oil.
Please subscribe to our channel and click on the little bell for new videos.
Welcome to Chefography Me. Today we have a guest chef cooking for you. Chef Insaf, all the way from India.
I'm going to cook stuffed fish wrapped in banana leaves. We are going to use today the sea bass. The stuffing, we have the grated coconut, garlic, shallots, curry leaves, crushed red chili. Black pepper, chili powder, salt, coconut oil, some lemon juice. I'm going to mix. Now I'm going to stuff sea bass. Just need to put the salt, some lemon juice, this I mix the coconut. I'm going to stuff this coconut. Sauce for the fish.